become a student on the PhD program on education in the Knowledge Society School. The research that I am carrying out within this program is about to analyze the certification of mobile application in the medical education purpose. So the director of my thesis were Juan Antonio Juanes and Francisco José García Peñalba. The goal of this presentation is to share with you the initial results that I have during the first year of this study. The presentation is structured as follows. First of all, a brief introduction with the main reasons that came up with the project. And then I continue with the investigation project itself. That was the first work that I had to deliver this during this first year. And it covers the hypothesis, the own objectives, the methodology, the resource, and the planification. And I will finish with the first results and then the conclusion. The main reasons that I came up with the project was that that the growth of the mobile phones has been growing dramatically since the last decade. So nowadays there are more than 50 million users in Spain with a mobile line. And this growth and the appearance of smartphones create a new business opportunity in the marketplace with the mobile applications. For example, there are more than 1 million of mobile applications in each marketplace, in the main marketplace, Play Store and the Apple Store. And second, this growth has impacted on society in all sectors, even in medical industry. And according to the General Medical Council, there are more about 51% of physicians that use a smartphone in their daily task, in majority for looking information, and then there are about 29% of them that use tablets for the same purpose. So all this data gave us that there is an increasing tendency of these of the mobile phones, and besides, there is an awareness of mobile application and a certification, and it doesn't exist a certification for a specialized certification for mobile phone, for mobile apps. And all these reasons make us raise some questions and to investigate about how is this project came brought up. So this is a summary of my investigation project. A summary framework. So I start with the research justification that I have just explained to you, and then I divide the study into study one and study two. And each study has their own hypotheses and objectives, and then all this data match with the methodology and combined with the resource, the planification, and the reference came up with the investigation project that, as I said, was the first work that I have to deliver. And let's see the hypothesis and objectives. As I said, I divide the project in two parts, study one and study two. The main goal of my research is to create a new certification, a new quality protocol for mobile apps, medical mobile apps. And in order to achieve this, I have that the main objective for study one was to measure the acceptance of technology from students, medical students, and from medical professionals. And then once I have this information, I would like to design the quality protocol, and I would like to validate it with a commercial mobile app. So then the hypotheses I defined were according to these objectives. For example, for study one, I say that undergraduate students have one mobile app and they use for the learning. And for study two, for example, I say that the quality protocol offers a quality and a trust guarantee for the user. And besides that, this, for example, this certification that I would like to create, it will be extended to any other mobile app. This was the initial hypothesis. And then the methodology. Well, the methodology for me, it was the main, the core of the investigation project. It was very hard at first because I only had the general idea, and it took me a little effort to work in so many details when I only had one idea. But then I think it's worth it to work on it because it helps you to organize your ideas and to know what you are going to achieve and how you are going to achieve it for the research. The methodology was divided in the design, the variables and instruments, the samples and population, and the data collection. And all these data have always in mind the diffusion through Congress, publication, and articles, because it's the way that you have to make your work be known by the rest of the people. So based on this, I designed that the study one was based on a technology acceptance model. I use a self-administered survey, and the predictor variables or independent variables were the age, gender, profile of the participants, the frequency of use of mobile phones, and then the criteria variables or dependent variables, what is precisely what I would like to measure, where they use and acceptance of technology. Then the target population were undergraduate students and medical professionals in Salamanca, because my research is enclosed here, and then the samples were the service collected. For study two, I designed a practical experimental project based on self-administered surveys and observation as well. The predictor variables were the profile and the behavior of the participant, and the criteria variables were the dimensions of the protocol. The target population was the same than study one, and the samples were the participants to validate the mobile application based on availability criteria. In both cases, in both studies, I used the program SPSS to analyze the collected data and in a statistical way, the person correlation and factorial analysis, etc. The resource and planification, once I have clear what I would like, how I want to achieve, I have to fix the resources and the planification. So I divide the project in three years, identify all the tasks for each study, and then I add a new part at the beginning for the definition of the research, and a new app at the end as the redaction of the thesis itself. So it helped me a lot in order to know what were the tasks that I have to do in the coming years, and then it helped you to organize your time as well, in order that you don't miss anything for the research. And then once we have seen the investigation project that, as I say, was the first work that I have to deliver this first year, I would like to show the results, the first result that I came with the two studies. So for study one, that I would like to measure the acceptance of technology from students and medical professionals, I use a 5-point Likert scale based on a technology acceptance model of Davis. And the most striking result for me was the 70% of the participants consider necessary a certification for medical application. And besides, the range of score for the acceptance fluctuates from 29 and 38 points over a maximum of 50, which is very positive. And then the third interesting result was the 34% of medical professionals use medical mobile apps for education. So whereas there is only 4.5% of the students that use medical applications. So it was a little bit shocking at first for me because it's against the hypothesis that I have considered at the beginning. So I have to reject this hypothesis. And the results for study two, the study two, I have to design a draft for protocol. And then I validated in a practical way using a commercial mobile phone, or a commercial mobile app, sorry. And the app was an anatomical brain app that shows the structure of the brain in three dimensions. And to achieve this, I divide one group in two randomly, and then each group receives a speech from the same teacher. One of them receives a normal class, the control group, and the experimental group receives a brief explanation of the mobile app. Then the experimental group had to fill or to answer a survey to validate the protocol that I have created, and then they have to fill a significant survey adjustment. Both groups, besides, they have to answer a knowledge questionnaire in order to measure the results before and after the speech. And what were the main results? Both of them got better results after the speech. However, the experimental group obtained more correct answers after the speech than the control group. Second, the mean score of both were good, but with the experimental group, they obtained a score higher than with the control group. And third, that the dimensions that I consider, the first dimensions that I consider for the protocol, it seems that can be considered suitable to validate the protocol and the mobile application can be okay, positive for the students, but it's necessary to make some changes in order to improve some features of the mobile application. So let's finish with the conclusion. And the three points that I would like to mark is that the project investigation is the first step of the thesis, and for me, I think it's very important and it's worth it to work on it. Second, the first striking result of the first year is that 70% of participants consider necessary a mobile certification for mobile application. And first, the first draft of the quality protocol that I have designed could be considered suitable to validate the mobile application. And that's all. Thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, please feel free to answer me.